Give him praise. Hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let's take our congregational chant. What a day that will be. Praise God. What a day that will be when my Jesus I shall see and I look upon his face. The one who saved me by his grace. When he takes me by the hand and lead me through the promised land. What a day, glorious day that will be. Hallelujah. That will be. Upon his face, the one who saved me by his grace, when he saved me by the hand, and he upon his face, what a day, what a day, that will be, what a day. What a day that will be.
Yes.
When we shall be reunited with our loved one that has gone ahead of us.
Yes.
We know that we have hope. We have the assurance.
Amen.
That soon and very soon we shall see the face of our Lord. Our battle is not in vain. Our fight is not in vain.
Amen.
Our labor is not in vain. Our struggle is not in vain. There is a day that is coming.
Yes. Yes.
When Jesus will wipe away all our tears. That day is coming. Can you sing that song one more time with me? What a day that will be. Hallelujah. comforted with by this song. You have lost loved ones. You have lost loved ones. Be comforted. If you are buried, be comforted. If you are sorrowful, be comforted. There's a day that is coming. If you are mourning, be comforted.
That will be when my Jesus I shall see.
My God, my God.
Then I look upon His face.
Magnify your name. We give you praise. Somebody lift up your hands and just worship Him. Magnify His holy name in this place. Thank Him for His salvation. Thank Him for saving you. Thank Him for calling you. Thank Him for the glorious hope that we have in Him. Father, we bless your name for your presence in this place. We thank you for the atmosphere that has been charged by your power and by your presence. Lord, we thank you because of your love towards us. We thank you because, God, you loved us and you gave your Son Jesus to die on the cross of Calvary for us. We thank you because you were wounded for our transgressions. You were bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement for our peace was upon you. And by your stripes we are healed. Father, we thank you for the gathering of the saints today. We thank you for your presence in this place. We thank you for your power that is present in this place. Father, we commit our gathering to your hand. We ask, oh God, that you come and have your way and tabernacle among us today. We thank you because of our fellowship, oh God, shall be greater today. We thank you because of the outpouring of your Spirit. We thank you for your Holy Spirit of God that is here to comfort us, to edify us, to bless us. We thank you because, Lord, we know that we are here today. As we are gathered together, our lives shall not be the same. Lord, we thank you because, Lord, as we are here, oh God, as our faces are different, so are our needs. Lord, we ask, oh God, that you meet every man and woman today at the point of need. We ask, oh God, that, Lord, your heavens will rend. You rend the heavens and pour out your Spirit. That, God, your power will heal and will save and will deliver. In the name of Jesus, we thank for the blessed assurance that we have, that soon and very soon, that we shall see your face. Thank you because, Lord, that day is coming, oh God, when you shall wipe away all our tears, when our struggle shall come to an end, when our labor shall come to an end. We thank for this glorious hope that we have in you, and we bless you, oh God. We thank for what you are about to do in this service. We thank you because about to do, oh God, in our lives. We thank because at the end of this service, our lives shall not be the same. Our ministry shall not be the same. Our family shall not be the same. Our career shall not be the same. Thank you because you shall stretch forth your hand to heal somebody today. In the name of Jesus, we pray for the sick. We pray, oh God, that you stretch forth your hand and touch those that are sick. In the name of Jesus, I come against sickness and disease. I come against every power of the enemy causing infirmity. I bind every spirit that want to keep people, the people of God, bound in sickness. In the name of Jesus, we release the healing flow. We release the healing power of God in this place. Thank you, oh God, for those who are shut in. Thank you because today, oh Lord, there's liberty, there's freedom, and there's salvation in the name of Jesus. We thank you for our youth. We thank you for our elders. We thank you for our parents. We thank you, oh God, for our brothers and sisters. We thank you for our country. We pray, oh God, that you begin to minister to the needs of your people in this place. In the name of Jesus, I speak into the wisdom table of the enemy. I overrule the counsel of the enemy. Overrule the wiles of the enemy. I overrule the plans and strategies of the wicked one against our lives, against our family, against our homes, against our nation, in the name of Jesus. Thank you because somebody at the sound of my voice today will receive a touch touch from God. Somebody will turn away from iniquity to righteousness. Thank you, because somebody, oh God, today will be saved. Somebody's life will be transformed. Have your way in our gathering. Thank you for the preaching of the word of God today. Mantle your man servant with the anointing of the Holy Ghost, that we might bring forth your word, oh God, as the oracle of God. Thank you for the praise and worship team. Thank you for the pastors. Thank you for our bishop. Thank you for our mother in the Lord. Thank you for their families. Lord, continue to strengthen them. Continue to weaken them, oh God. Continue to encourage them, oh God, to continue to keep on keeping on, in the name of Jesus, knowing fully that their labor shall not be in vain. Thank you for everyone that is here. We commit this service into your hand. Holy Spirit of God, have your way. Thank you for your presence. We bless you and we worship you. We magnify your name. In the name of Jesus. Somebody put your hands and give him praise. Give him praise. Hallelujah. Lord, we worship you. Lord, we bless your holy name. Lord, we magnify your name. Take absolute control. Thank you for the anointing to break every yoke. Thank you for the anointing to lift every burden. Thank you for transformation. Thank you because, oh God, we know that you are here and we shall have an encounter with you. In the precious, matchless name of Jesus, we have worship. And everybody say, amen. Put those hands once more and give him praise. Give him the highest praise. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise God. You may be seated in God's wonderful presence as I invite the Public Relations Ministry for welcome, recognition, and announcement. God bless you.
Good morning, church.
God bless.
Good morning, Faith Tabernacle.
Good morning.
This is a wonderful day that our Lord has made. Can we be happy? Let us rejoice in it. Can we say hallelujah?
Hallelujah.
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 Praise the name of the Lord. This morning I welcome you to our service. I speak to you who are here in the sanctuary, those of you who had made some time to let us gather together as a body of Christ, those of you who are listening by way of radio, welcome to our service. We thank you for sharing with us each Sunday morning. We thank God for the opportunity and the freedom to come into his presence each day, especially on a Sunday. And we say, welcome, welcome, welcome. You are always welcome here. And we welcome you always as we welcome the Holy Spirit this morning. On behalf of our Bishop Butterfield, our Lady Rosita Butterfield, who is here with us this morning, all of the deacons and pastors on the podium, and those of us who call this place our place of worship, it is a pleasure to stand here, to say welcome, to recognize our visitors, and to give you the announcements for this week. Do we have any first-time visitors this morning? Anybody who is worshiping here for the very first time? Or maybe it's not your first time, but it's been a while since you've been in the church with us. Could you lift your hands? Let us see where you are. Okay. Seems as if we are regular visitors. We thank you. We see Sister Taylor is back with us, and we also want to recognize, even before we move to the other announcement, that though she's here after the loss of her son-in-law, she's mourning today the loss of her brother-in-law. So let us remember her in our prayers, and the Taylor, the Adams family, and their sister Virginia on the loss of her husband. So I'm going to ask you, let us just stand together where we are. We're going to celebrate Jesus, celebrate, and I'm going to ask you to take the opportunity to just move around and greet each other this morning. Stand with me, church. Celebrate Jesus, celebrate.
Celebrate, celebrate, Jesus, celebrate, celebrate,
To us by Deacon Williams, Deacon Herbert Williams. If you turn with me to the back of your program, our announcements for the week are regular announcements, and for those of you who are listening, they are as follows. Prayer meeting, Monday, 7:30 p.m. Midday prayer meeting, weekdays except Monday and Wednesday, between 12 and 1 p.m. Bible study, Wednesday, 7:30. Evangelistic outreach, Thursdays, 5 p.m. Youth meeting, Friday, 7:30. Praise team rehearsal on Saturday at 6. A Bible class, each Sunday morning starts 9:45, followed by divine worship and our biblical conversations on each afternoon, 7:30. There is not one schedule for this afternoon, so I suggest you check with Brother Floyd after church for confirmation. Remember to let us always be in prayer for the sick and the shut-in, for the young people of our country, for those in authority, and that men everywhere may be safe. We ask you always to remember the families that have lost loved ones, to remember those that are sick, those that are shut-in, and we ask that you remember our dear sister Sonia, who is not with us this morning. You know she's traveling, so let us remember her and Brother Sam in our prayers as we go through the week. Also, if you are in need of transportation to church, please feel free to call Pastor Kenneth, 342-8095. Pastor Kenneth, thank you.
Put your hands together and give God praise. Thank you, Sister Kerr. Praise God. It's now time for tithes and offerings. Praise God. Let's put our hands and give God praise. Hallelujah. Praise God. It's always a delight to be able to give to God out of what God has given to us. It's an integral part of worship. Praise God. There are many ways you worship God. You worship God by the fruit of your lips, praise, you sing, and then you praise God for all that he has done for you. But when you bring our gifts, our offerings, our tithes, it's also a part of worship. Praise God. By saying, Father, we worship you for all that you have given unto us. And we recognize you as the source of everything that we have. So this morning, I want you to stand to your feet as we bring our offerings to worship God this morning. Praise God. We have to give because, first of all, God gave us his son, Jesus, to die on the cross of Calvary for us. Hallelujah. So we're only giving him just a token because we love him. Praise God. We can't outgive God. There's nothing we can give that will equal to the love that he has shown us. Are we ready to give this morning? Do you have an offering this morning? Let's stand to your feet as we give. Praise God. Bring out your offering and let me bless it and give. As we give, just bring us something tangible, bring something qualitative to give to God this morning. Praise God. Can we stand to our feet if you want to give to God this morning? Are we tired? Don't be tired when it's time to give to God. Praise God. Hallelujah. I'm sure the children, you have something to give. I make sure every morning I give my children something, an offering to give to God. The same thing, the youths, you should always learn to give to God. Start to give now. You have to know how to give at this stage of your life so that God can bless you in your later stage. You have to learn how to tithe, how to give, how to show appreciation to God. Praise God. Can we all stand, lift up your hands with your seed in your hands. Pray that we thank you for the opportunity and the privilege to give this morning. We thank you because everything we have, you gave to us. there's no single thing that we have that belongs to us. Everything belongs to you. Therefore, we acknowledge you as a giver of life. We acknowledge you as our source. We acknowledge you as our provider. We acknowledge you as the one that supplies all of our needs according to your riches in glory in Christ Jesus. We thank you for everything that you have done for us. Thank you for food on our table. Thank you for shelter. Thank you for transportation. Thank you, oh God, because we can sleep and we wake up. Thank you because, Lord, we are alive today in the land of the living. We thank you because we have food to eat, oh God. Many don't have, but we thank you. Lord, this morning, Lord, we give our seed, we give our offering. Lord, we thank you because as we give your word says, Lord, you give your angels charge concerning us to keep us in all our ways. Your word says you rebuke the devourer for our sake, oh God. Your word says, oh God, when we give, oh God, we shall receive in good measure, praise and shaking together and running over shall men give unto our bosom. Father, Lord, we ask that you bless the seed in our hands, oh God. We ask that you multiply it, oh God. Little becomes much when it's committed into your hand. Therefore, Lord, let this offering be used to the propagation of the gospel. Let it be used to your own glory in the name of Jesus. Father, as we pray for those who don't have to give this morning. We ask that, oh God, next time we gather, you put something in their hands to give. Because it's more blessed to give than to receive in the name of Jesus. We bless you. We break the hands of the enemy and the hand of the wicked over our finances, over our labor, over our endeavors, over our ministry, over our businesses. In the name of Jesus, Satan, the blood of Jesus is against you. Lose your hold from our money in the name of Jesus. And we command money to come to us from the east, from the west, from the north, from the south. In the name of Jesus, thank you. We bless you. And we rejoice in all that you have given to us. In Jesus' name we are praying. Everybody say amen. Amen. Come rejoice and come and give to God this morning. Praise God. We bring the sacrifice of praise into the house of the Lord.
We bring sacrifice of praise into the house of the Lord. We bring sacrifice of praise into the house of the Lord. Sacrifices of thanksgiving, and we offer up to you the sacrifices of praise. We bring sacrifice of praise into the house of the Lord. We bring sacrifice of praise into the house of the Lord. Sacrifices of thanksgiving, and we offer up to you the sacrifices of praise.
God is great.
God is great, and greatly to be praised. Glory, glory to his name. God is great, and greatly to be praised. Bless the Lord, oh my soul.
I will bow
before his majesty. I will lift my hands and sing. God is great and greatly to be praised. Bless the Lord, oh my soul.
Bless the Lord.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul.
Bless the Lord.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul.
Bless the Lord.
Bless the Lord, oh.
Thanks and giving praise. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. At this time, we want to pray for our GSAT students. We have students who are about to take their GSAT exam this week. I think it's on Tuesday. Praise God. If you are here, I want you to just come to the front and Pastor Ruby will pray for you. If you are taking the exam this week, it's not of him that will it, it's not of him that run it, it's God that show it mercy. So let's pray for God's mercy and God's favor upon your life. You may have read, you must have studied, but you need a breath of God for success to come your way. Praise God. I believe that in our midst, at least we'll have people that will excel and come on top. Praise God. So God will bless you. Can we ask Reverend Ribby to come and pray for them? Praise God.
Thank you, Pastor Kenneth. It is so important that we cover our children. It was yesterday I attended a family member funeral. And there were so many young people that were there. In fact, more than half of the church had young people occupying the pews. And there were such a outburst of sorrow on behalf of the young people. When they looked at what was happening. I say that to say this. As parents, as church leaders, it is so important that we cover our children, speak the blood of Christ over their lives, because we never know what could happen. We've seen what's happening in the world today. Hallelujah. And so I want you who will know the name of Jesus, even if as we pray for these youngsters this day, I want you to extend your right hand towards them, right where you are, and come into agreement as we pray. Father in glory, we thank you for these young minds. Lord, as they come this day before the altar, the old-fashioned altar, they come in faith knowing that you, your blessings is assured. And Father, as your dear children, we plead the blood of Calvary. Oh, the blood that will never lose its power over their lives right now. Father, we pray, dear God, that your blood would encompass them, would build a hedge around them. Dear God, we pray that their young minds will be open up, and even when they take the GSAT exams. Oh God, I pray right now that their understanding will be enlightened, that they will glorify you. They will do their best, God. Oh Father, but not only that, we pray that you will secure them, that you will seal them, that you will preserve their lives, that the enemy will not be able to touch them. Dear Father, we pray, dear God, even as the word go forth today, that it will take root within their heart, and they will cry out if they don't yet know you as Lord and Savior. Dear God, we cover them by the blood of Calvary, even to the youngest, to the eldest. We cover them by the blood of Calvary. We plead the blood over their lives. We plead redemption over their lives. We plead salvation over their lives. We plead deliverance over their lives. Cover them in the name of Jesus. Preserve them, Lord. Lord, as the minister go and touch each one of them, we pray, dear God, that your spirit will settle on them, control their lives, that they would be productive citizens in this place. Oh, Father, we come against the spirit that are going around in this country with this rebellious spirit that our young people are embracing. We cuss it in the name of Jesus. We come against the spirit of death. We come against the spirit of indifference. We come against it in the name of Jesus. And we hold fast to the faith of you, God, who are able to do all things. In Jesus' name we pray. Hallelujah. And the church say, amen. And the church say, hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Victory is sure. We have the victory. The only way you are going to lose a battle is if you don't fight as a child of God. The only way you lose the battle, I don't care what you are fighting now, is if you don't fight. If you have God on your inside, on your side, then victory is certain. Victory is yours concerning any battle that you are fighting right now. But we have to know that God does not initiate any battle. It's us that will what initiate the battle. All he wants us is to show up and he will give us the victory. If you step out, he will back you up. Are you hearing me? Hallelujah. And he will see to it that you prevail. Praise God. Hallelujah. And we know that our God is never on the losing side. So we are on the winning side. Tell yourself, I am on the winning side. Praise God. I am on the winning side. Hallelujah. If your God is always on the winning side, that means you are always on the winning side. Thanks be to God who always causes us to triumph in Christ Jesus. Somebody put your hands and give him praise. Let's release the spirit of victory in this place. Let's stir up that spirit that guarantees victory in every fight. We are on the winning side. Hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah. Victory is for you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise God. I will not give up until I win. I don't know about you. Praise God. I will not give up until I win. I know that the Spirit of God is here right now. I know the Spirit of God is here right now. I hear God telling somebody, you got to fight. Don't wait. Just fight. Show up. Don't give up. The spirit of discouragement has been released into the body of Christ. And many are getting tired. Many are getting weary. Many are getting frustrated. Let us fight the good fight of faith. I don't care what the situation is right this morning. Rise up and fight. Receive that spirit of victory right now. In the name of Jesus, you will not be defeated. In the name of Jesus, hallelujah, you will not be put to shame. God says, somebody, you will not be put to shame. God said, I will not put you to shame. I brought you this far, not to leave you. I brought you this far, not to forsake you. I will give you the victory, and you know that I am God. Somebody put your hands and give him praise. Hallelujah. I remember that saying that said, tough times never last, but tough people do. Praise God. Hallelujah. We know that our God will stand by our side until we win. Hallelujah. Praise God. Let's welcome right now the praise team as they lead us into the presence of God. Praise God. Put your hands and give God praise for their lives.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Those of you who did feel discouraged by now, after Pastor Kenneth speak, you should be brave now. You should be encouraged to go on. Hallelujah. You should be able to thank God for this day. Thank God for this very moment. Thank God that you are here to hear the word of God this morning, what Pastor Kenneth is saying. Do not be discouraged. Continue to fight. And let us give God thanks for this day, because this is a new day. Just as it's a new rising of the sun, it's a new day with new mercies, new blessings, and new favor today. Hallelujah. For somebody shall rejoice today. Hallelujah. Somebody shall have a breakthrough today. Hallelujah. Just open up your mouth and begin to praise him, because God has given you a mouth and you use your mouth to praise him. He has given you your hands and you use your hand. If you choose to praise him, praise him today, because he deserves the praises. And even if you don't praise him, he is still faithful. And he is God all by himself. So you might as well praise him this morning. Hallelujah. You might as well give him thanks. Because do not take this day lightly. because many have gone on, but you are here this morning. It's nothing good that we have done, but because of the mercies of God that we are here this morning. Hallelujah. But God has waken us up. And this is how we should be when we see another day. And we can move our feet. And we can move our hands. And we know that this is the day that the Lord had made. We should give him thanks. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, give him thanks this morning. Hallelujah. 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 As we sing, fill my way with love. Hallelujah. This should be our request this morning. Let me walk, blessed Lord, in the way thou hast gone. Leading straight to that land above. Giving cheer everywhere to the sand and the loam. Fill my way every day with love. Come on, lift your voice.
Let me walk, blessed Lord, in the way thou hast gone. Leading straight to that land above.
Every day with love. Hallelujah. Keep me close to the side of my Savior and guide. Let me never in darkness roam. Keep my path free from wrath and my soul satisfied. Hallelujah, with Jesus we'll be satisfied. Hallelujah, every day we will be filled with love. This should be our request. Then we will be able to do things better once we walk closely with God. Hallelujah. He will never let us roam. This is the God that we are serving this morning. This is the God that we can boast about this morning. I will boast not in any other thing, but I will boast about God this morning. He is my source. He is my strength. He is my desire. This is my desire this morning. Because he is everything to us this morning. This should be our desire to worship him with all our hearts. Not part of us, but everything we should do our best. Hallelujah. To honor him. Lord, with all my heart I worship you. Because everything that I have within him, I give him praise this morning. Hallelujah. Come on, are you ready to sing that song? This is my desire. Come on and love the Lord as you sing it. If you know that this is your desire this morning, sing it from the depths of your heart this morning. Hallelujah.
To honor you, Lord, with all my heart, I worship you.
Come on, tell him all I have in you, everything that lives in me this morning.
All I have within me, I give. Within me, I give you.
Your way, God. Hallelujah. Have your way in our service today, Lord. Have your way in our homes today, Lord. Have your way in our country today, Lord. We present it to you, God. Hallelujah. Because there is none like you, Lord. You are the Lamb of God, which taketh away the sin of the world. And we want to give you the highest praise. Hallelujah. Because you alone is worthy to receive all praise and glory. So this morning as we lift those praises to you, God, we'll ask that the blessing will come down, that things will begin to change, Lord. Circumstances will be changed this morning. Somebody will be able to celebrate. Somebody will have a new day today. Hallelujah. 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 Someone will heal. Hallelujah. Someone will say, I'm tired of being doing my own thing. But God, I want to be the one you want me to be. I want to be the person that you want me to be today. Hallelujah. As we sing, hallelujah. Praise the Lamb. Hallelujah. Praise the Lamb. For he alone is worthy to receive all praise and glory. Lift them higher today in one accord. Lift your praises to the Lord. Come on, some of you give it a praise this morning. Let us praise him like we never praised him before. Because my heart sings his praise again. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Hallelujah. Your praise. Hallelujah, hallelujah, your praise, the Lamb.
your praise.
Come on and lift your praises to the Lord.
Praises to the Lord.
Oh, you ought to lift your praises to the Lord.
Lift your praise.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Praises to the Lord.
We gotta lift him higher today.
Lift him higher.
And one accord.
One accord.
Lift your praises. Lift your praises.
Lift your
and give God praise. Thank you, worship team, for taking us into the presence of God. Without much ado, we want to present to you the preacher for today, the man that has the word of God in his mouth to present to us the word of God today. Prepare yourself to receive what the Lord has in store for you today. Receive with me, stand to your feet as we welcome Deacon Herbert Williams to present the word of God. Make him feel welcome. God bless you.
God be the glory, great thing he has done. I want to say pleasant good afternoon to you all. It is good to be in God's house another time. First, I want to greet our pastor, the first lady, and his family, deacon, minister, brethren, and friend. And for those of you who are in Radio Land, I want to greet you in the matchless name of Jesus Christ, our soon coming King. Indeed, it's a great opportunity for me to be here this morning to share God's word with you. And I am blessed since Sunday school. Most of what I really have studied for the past 2 weeks, Pastor Rigby has gone through all this. If we did talk over the past 2 weeks, I would say he already stole the stuff that I have to say, but I believe he's one spirit, and I'm happy for that. This morning, I want to share with you brief about, I wanted to just turn the Bibles to the book of Acts chapter 7, reading verse 54. Acts chapter 7, verse 54. And it said, "Now when they heard this, they were cut to quick, and they began snatching their teeth at him. But being full of the Holy Spirit, he gazed intensively in heaven and saw the glory of God and Jesus standing at the right hand of God. And he said, 'Behold, I see the heaven open up and the Son of Man standing at the right hand of God.' But they cried out with a loud voice and covered their ears and rushed at him with one impulse. When they had driven him out of the city, they began stoning him, and the witnesses lay aside their robe at the feet of a young man named Saul. They went on stoning Stephen as he called on the Lord and said, 'Lord Jesus, receive my spirit.' Then falling on his knees, and he cried out with a loud voice, 'Lord, do not hold this sin against them.' Having said this, he fell asleep." Here, in a portion of God's word, we all say amen. This morning, as I here said in brief, Stephen, as I said, Pastor Rigby already speak what really happened. It was a time when the church or the Christian was under attack. These disciples was under attack by the other Pharisees, Sadducees, and all these other groups of people. And the disciples, the reason for the attack is because they was preaching in the name of Jesus Christ. And this offended most of these other religious people. Talking about God was not their problem, but it was about talking about Jesus Christ. But these disciples, or these followers of Jesus Christ, made it make it a purpose of their heart that they will not denounce Jesus. Whatever it takes, they will continue to speak about Jesus Christ. And on many occasions, they was locked up, put in jail. One time they was in jail, and God allowed an angel to come and deliver them, and the jail door was still locked. The guard was guarding nobody inside, although they did not knew that. And that's the way that God worked. And when they went and saw the jail door was locked, when they go to visit these disciples, he realized that they were not there. Where they was? They was at a different city proclaiming the name of Jesus Christ. And this irritate them more and more. So they decided that they have to do something, because these disciples, the more they put them under pressure, the more they expand the name of Jesus, and they was angry about that. So, during the time of my study, Stephen really come up to me. Because all these other disciples things happened, but Stephen, and why Stephen? And why they target Stephen? There was a time when there was a problem about the widow, where the widow was neglected, and they want to
pay attention to the widow, but they said that the word of God is more important to preach. So they formed groups, and it happened that Stephen was one of the head of the group. So they see Stephen as a group leader, wearing, proclaiming Jesus' name, the name of Jesus. And they decided they would have to put an end to Stephen's life. What they did, they take him before the Sanhedrin council, and they tried him, and they threatened him, and Stephen know the consequences if he refused from cooperate with them. If he continued to talk about Jesus, the penalty would, they will stone him to death. And this stone, as I said, to death. And because of death is something that terrify or scared many people. But this did not scare Stephen. Stephen, when they take him before the council, Stephen preach. Or Stephen tell him as it is. He went into the New Testament, in the Old Testament from Moses' time, and he came right up to Jesus Christ. And this caused these people to more angry. So what they did, they put him before, because they formed a group of people who could lie. And they tell them, okay, let's say Steve, we heard him out of our own ears that he blasphemed against God. And they get this group to lie and form this thing against him. And they said it, and Stephen was stoned to death. But death could not stop Stephen. Stephen don't allow this to stop him, because Stephen realized that death is not the end, but death is the beginning. You see, Stephen's death caused a lot of more people to heard about Jesus Christ. And this morning, during my time of study, I started to think about death. Because death is one of the most scariest things to mankind. Men do not like to hear about it. And we don't hear much of it in church, only at a funeral service. But this morning, I want to talk about death. And my topic this morning, after death. After death. Because we have to understand what death really is. If I ask the question this morning, what is death? I could get a lot of different answers, opinion, what death really is. But death is simpler from life. If you do not have life, you is dead. You see, just like this little girl talk about death, just like some of us. And this morning, first I want to send out my condolences to those who have loved one who's gone. I've been there. I know what it is to have a loved one passed away. I understand that. Death is not easy things to deal with, especially sometimes if we do not understand what death really is. It is very important this morning when I saw Pastor Kenneth call his young people to pray for them about the exam. But it's more than even the exam. Is we need to try to allow them to understand that their life is very important to God. They need to submit themselves to God. They need to accept Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior. Because whether you want it or not, death is appointed to man. We might not like it, but it will happen. And that first time, death is most for the older folks. But today we have more young people dying than the old people, if I should put it that way. We see, especially here, in such a short time, so many young lives had passed on by the cold hands of death. I want to talk about death today, because death is something to address. That we need to understand what death is all about. Death is a door to eternity. Let I repeat, death is a door to eternity. Whether eternity with God or eternity in the hell. But death is a door to eternity. When you're dead, that's the end of this life here. But it does not stop there. Because every man will have to give account of what he or she have done with their life on this side of life. So this morning I want to pose the question, after death, what? Today, I want you to understand that even if you messed up time or yesterday, but today we could make it right. Yesterday is a cancer check. Today is a ready one. Don't tell me about tomorrow, because tomorrow is a promissory note. Does not have no guarantee to change. But today, death is a sure for all. Once a little girl was cutting through a cemetery, and her friend asks, "Why should you do such a thing?" And she said, "It was the shortest way home. The cemetery is a short way home. Death is a short way home. But in the midst of death, are you ready?" It is very important for us to be ready, because death have no manners. Death have no style or special way. Death does not look on status in society. Does not know about age. Because from birth to 100 and maybe 50, 60. First time now, people don't go that. I think the oldest person is maybe 115 or 20 now. But it don't go that far anymore. As time goes on, it cuts shorter and shorter. But it's a sure thing. But you have to make sure you are ready for death. A father was dying. He had his family around him. He had only a few minutes to live. He had four children. He said, "Good night, John. Good night, Butch. Good night, Betty. Goodbye, Ralph." Ralph was mad. He said, "Wait a minute. You said goodbye, good night to my sibling, but you say to me goodbye." His father looked at him and said, "All the other three accept Jesus Christ as their savior, but you did not. I will see them in glory, but I don't sure about you." Today, I want to say to you that let it be a part of our duty today to make sure Jesus Christ is Lord of our life. This world is coming to an end. This Christian journey that we are in, it's under attack. Our faith is under attack. In United Kingdom, it is said that every 10 young people, one is changed to Muslim. Muslim religion is the fastest growing religion in the world. If you do not understand who are Muslim or what was their purpose, Muslim was formed to destroy the Christian in Rome. That was their duty, to destroy. And don't believe that you could get them work together. It will not happen. Because if you is not in the Muslim world, if you is not a Muslim, you is an infidel. That's the way that they see it. And that's why they said, especially in Iran, that they want to wipe out Israel off the map. You see, we have to understand the world that we are living in today. Death is scary, but it's going to happen to us. You see, I love Monopoly. I don't know how many of you play that game. That's a very nice game. I love it. It makes you feel like you're doing real business. When I play, man, I feel strong. I like to take something and craft into a building. It is to see how I can expand. It's more when I play this game, I get very anxious, excited. In the way I try to overcome. You see, my main goal in playing Monopoly is to get Park Place and Boardwalk. You see, those two are the biggest on the board. You see, when I get Park Place and Boardwalk, and I put on houses or hotel and those, anybody land on those two have to pay me rent. Big rent too. Especially Boardwalk. They are the most valuable property on the board. If I get those two pieces of property, then I began to build my Danny neighborhood or empire. I feel powerful. I will put up some greenhouse and started charging rent. And if you cannot pay, then you must leave the game. I am the boss. I am playing big. There is also a depressing time when I am playing Monopoly. That is when the game is over. It is then that I am reminded it was all a game. You see, when the game is over, the greenhouse, the red hotel, and all the paper money must go back into the box. Then we close the box and come back to the real world. It's just a game. But today I want to tell you that in spite of all that we are getting and doing, one day the box will close. In all that you achieve on the side of life and all that you hype up and all things that is happening good for you, the time is coming when the box will close. It will not matter what you left behind because it is going to go to someone else. All that you work for, hard for, sometime you deprive yourself, sometime even things that you could enjoy, you do not enjoy because you are trying to build up an empire. But it is coming to an end. One day, the box will close. It doesn't matter how good you are on the side of life, how kind you are. One day, the box will close. What then? The box will close. The game is over. What then? You might be a good preacher, a good singer, a good this, a good that, whatever you want to. All the titles sometimes, so many titles behind your name. But one day, the box will close. What then? I want to give you time today to look back into yourself and say, if today the box is closed, what then? Because the box will close. Everything will pack up. What then? We all need to come to that reality. An old man asks a young man, "What are you doing with your life?" The young man replied, "I am going to college and get a business degree. The old man said, "Well, what then? Oh, then I am going up to New York, and I am going to work on the Wall Street because I become a broker and then become a millionaire." "Okay, what then?" The boy continued, "Then I am going to buy myself a fine house. I may try to retire early so that I can enjoy good life. What then?" "Well, then after I going to party, relax, and enjoy my grandkids." "All right, what then?" "I guess after all that, I going to die." It doesn't matter where you go around the world, it's coming to one place, death. You see, I understand death, and I was looking death now and death then, and how it really work. I remember in my younger days, I'm not old anyhow, but in my younger days, when somebody died, they would bury early because there was not like refrigerator, especially for the poorer class. They would get ice or maybe something else, and they would make those wooden coffin, and they would take them, guys carry them on something, some in those little pickup truck. There was not like now. When they lower them down, they would use rope. But today, it is different. You see, people today die in style. You see, if you never lie on a good pillow, linen, today you don't have to worry, because when you die, you're going uncertain. People die in style. You see, at the funeral parlor, there I call these people dead artists. They know how to fix up people when they are dead. They fix some people, they look better when they're dead than when they are alive. Die in style. But the fact remains, you're still dead. You see, I want to say today, nothing wrong with all these things, but we need to understand that the real you is not this that you're looking on. The reason why some people scared of death is because too much emphasis put on this. And the real you that within, we spend less time on the real you, which is the soul. We invest too many on this old body, which is corruption, that will go back to the earth. The Bible said, "From the earth cometh, and to the earth thou shalt return." That's the reason why this body go through so much things, because God have nothing to do with it. After a while, because it is corruption, it is going back to the ground. People die in style. Today, I see when you may not able to drive into a nice vehicle, but you still don't have to worry because you get limousine ride. Sometimes black road, the road is black to allow you to pass. Limousine. All these things is happening when you are dead. Some people, it don't happen here, but back home, some family member die from hungry. But when they're dead, amen, family from overseas, yes, yes, will spend thousands of dollars to accommodate the debt. And those same people, if you didn't send maybe $100, it could save them life from hunger. Debt. in style. So today, you see, you might not go down. They have something now where they use to lower you down in order for you not to disturb. You don't have to use rope anymore. They have that thing, I don't even know what they call it, lower you down inside that grave. Not for you to disturb. Dead in style. But in spite of all this thing, you are still dead. That does not mean anything. You see, I have bad news for you. Unless Jesus come back, you are going to die. Your death will not delay. Because of the Bible say, death by appointment. In Roman, in Hebrew 9 verse 27, it said, appointed unto man once to die. That will not stop death. Today, come look firmly. You see, folks, down at the funeral home, know how to let you look good. Fairly good when they are dead. Particular have professional makeup. Artists dress you up and make you look good. Make you seem better than when you was alive. Dead people used to put in all these kind of wooden coffin and stuff like that. But now today it's changed. You see, all these things do not change the perception that you are dead. Death is not your final home. Death is a step out of this life to the new life. And I want to tell you that Stephen was stoned to death, but Stephen make it right with Jesus Christ. Today, I want to say you might not stone with stone, but today you might stone with all different kinds of sickness. You might stone with cancer, but that will not stop you from making it in to your Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Once you make it right with God, today you might stone with AIDS and all different types of diseases that will plague this body, that will kill this body. But if you make Jesus Christ the Lord of your life, that will not stop you, because death is just a stepping from one place to another. Once you step out of this world, you will step into that new world. The Bible said, where you will deal with Jesus Christ. And you don't have to worry about what was happening on this side of life. Because the Bible said that we must lay treasure in heaven. Where moth and rot will not touch it. We must lay treasure up there. Sometimes we place too much emphasis on this side of life. So many times we place too much emphasis on this body. I went to the barbershop sometimes, and it is sad to say, oh, things change today. You have to wait, not for another man, but you have to wait on lady in the barbershop. And it's go around. I see lady go to the barber, to the hairdresser nowadays, and they have to wait on men, because too much men there for appointment for the hairdresser. Things is changed so different now. Emphasis on this body here. So much men in the hairdresser parlor now. Sometimes you don't know who is who. Things is different. Emphasis on the body. But I want today to remind you that this body will dead someday. But you must put emphasis on the soul that is within you, because this is the one that will take you up into heaven, to that place where we said we will go around the throne of God and we'll say, holy, holy, Lord God Almighty. We need to put emphasis on the soul that will never die. We need to put emphasis on this thing who can worship God in spirit and in truth. We need to put emphasis on this, because one day the box will be closed. The box will be closed one day. And when the box is closed, what your answer will be? The Bible said we all stand before the judgment seat of Almighty God. And he said a book was open and another book will open. And if your name is not found in the Lamb's book of life, you will cast into the lake of fire. So don't believe when your death is stopped right there. Death is a transition from this life to another life. But you will have to stand before God and give account what you do with your life on this side of life. So it's very important for us to make it right on this side of life, that when Jesus Christ comes, whether he come in here or he take, if that box closed and he take you by the cold hand of death, you are ready to go with him. And you can go, and you can, when he take you, he can say, these are days that go to great persecution for me. Today you might be sick and afflicted with pain, all different kind of ailment. You might can hardly make it on the side of life, but I want to tell you, you can make it on broken pieces, because one day the Bible said that we will get a new body, hallelujah, a new life. That body will stand out. There will no more sickness to harm this body, no more arthritis, no more cancer, no more nothing, because that body will stand up, a body that can worship God, a body will can stand up and say, glory be to God in the highest, peace on earth towards all men. We will get a body who will able to walk on that street of gold. We'll get a body who can worship Jesus Christ 24/7, because this body cannot take that worship. Because if we stand here for another 2 hours, many people will fall asleep, because this body is corruption. This body is sin. But that body that we'll get, hallelujah, it will be a 24/7 worship body. I want to get that body, because hallelujah, there will be no boring there, because we don't have to worry about tomorrow, because there will be no more tomorrow. It will all today, and there will be worship, hallelujah, when we stand around that throne of God, and when we start to sing redemption story. Somebody said the angel will not be able to sing because they were not redeemed, but we know that we were redeemed, not with corrupted thing, but we was redeemed by the precious blood of Jesus Christ, hallelujah. When, what a day that will be, when my Jesus I shall see, when I look upon his face, and remember he gave me that saving grace. Somebody said he going to hold me by his hand, he going to take me to that promised land. What a day that will be, hallelujah. It will be a great redemption. It will be a great convention at that place, hallelujah. We'll sing. Somebody said the angel will fold their wing and they will listen to us singing, hallelujah. What a day. You see, when Jesus Christ, I always said, hallelujah, I never go up on that door shocker. I only fly 35,000 feet, but that is nothing compared to that Holy Ghost ride. When we in that Holy Ghost flight, hallelujah, and we'll go to Mars, Jupiter, Venus, hallelujah, we go to that stratosphere, go to that Milky Way, and we walk on that street of gold, hallelujah. When I was reading and I saw gold, jasper, and they say transpiring gold, I never see transpiring gold. I don't know what that look like, but that going to be something to see. Are you anticipate? My friend, I want to tell you today, go through what you are going through, because that going to be a great day, hallelujah. Transpiring gold, I don't understand, but I know that is possible, because if Jesus Christ, hallelujah, can build on this side of life, allow man to dig gold and melt it and look like this, what he cannot do? He going to give us walk on street of gold, hallelujah. And I not only that, but when we think about that place that he will build for us, hallelujah, mansion, hallelujah, transparent, so we can see from the four corners of the earth, hallelujah, there will be no night, because on this side of life, sometime power outage, sometime last week, I was home and the power gone, and I did not have enough light, and I bow to stumble, but there will be no stumble up there, because there will Jesus Christ. He will be the light of the world. What a day that will be. This morning I want to tell you, it doesn't matter what your body might go into. It doesn't matter what death threat, because death is only a easier way to go home, to start to enjoy life before the other come with you. My friend, keep on keeping on. Don't let Satan intimidate you with death. Death is not your final destination. Death is an easy way home. Hallelujah. Make sure though, when the box is closed, you are ready to be with the Lord. God bless you.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Put your hands and give God praise. Can we stand to our feet? Just stand to your feet, hallelujah, and just... Don't be too excited. This is a message that you have to think about. When the bus is closed, what then? What then? Somebody said the other day, you don't have to be old to die. Babies die. Toddlers die. The youth die. Teenagers die. Adults die. The old die. One day, we shall answer the call. It's appointed unto man once to die, but after that, judgment. Let's think about the message we have had today. For a child of God who have given his life to Christ, who is serving him with all their heart, in integrity, in faith, then there's nothing to fear about death. As he said, just a shortcut home. So you can afford to relax and enjoy your life here on earth. Are you hearing me? But if you have not given your life to Christ, if you are not sure that if you die today, if you are not sure that if he calls you today, if you are not certain that you make it to heaven, I want to give you this opportunity to come and give your life to Christ Jesus. Especially our youths and some of our adults that are here. If you are not sure, if you are not sure that when that box is closed, if you don't sure where you will be, why don't you come and give your life to Christ? Receive him as your Lord and Savior, and he's ever ready to receive you. Praise God. Hallelujah. Let's sing that song again. What a day that will be. Can you sing that song with me? What a day that will be. When Jesus I shall see. When I look upon his face, the one who saved me by his grace, when he takes me by his hand and lead me to the promised land, what a day, a glorious day that will be. Can we sing that song? If you are not sure of where we will be, why don't you step out here and pray for you and lead you to accept Jesus as Savior.
When I look upon his face, the one who saved me by his grace, when my Jesus.
shall see when I look upon his face, the one who saved me by his grace. When he takes me by the hand and leads me to the promised land.
Praise for what he has done in our assembly today. We want to say thank God. We want to thank the Holy Spirit for visiting us today. I want to thank the preacher for being obedient to God to preach and to speak the word of God today. I know that our lives will not be the same as a result of this preaching. And we know that as we live here today, we'll be certain that if we die today, we'll make heaven. If you are not sure, don't leave this place without giving your life to Christ. Let us pray. Father, we thank you for what you have done. We thank you for your word that has come forth expressly. We thank you because, Lord, you have reminded us again that, Lord, this world is not our home. We are just passing through. Father, we pray, oh God, that as many as have heard this word, that this message will not stand as a condemnation to them. But Lord, that we'll use this as an opportunity to amend our ways and to seek you today. Father, we thank you because there is nothing to fear about death, because you're the one that has destroyed death. You destroy the power of death, and you have given us life eternal. Father, I pray, oh God, as many, oh God, as still living in sin, in waywardness, in worldliness, those who are still attached to the things of the world, that through this message, oh God, they would relinquish everything and surrender themselves unto you. Father, I pray, oh God, that nobody would harden their heart to your word today. In the name of Jesus. Father, I pray for your children. I thank you because, Lord, you are here right now. I thank you, oh God, for those, oh God, who are going through one need, one problem or the other. Lord, I pray for them, oh God, for those who are experiencing problems in their marriages. I pray for those who are experiencing problems at their workplace. I pray for those who are experiencing problems in their health, in their bodies. I pray for those who are experiencing problems in their businesses. Lord, I pray for those, oh God, who have been betrayed or disappointed in one way or the other, oh God. I pray for those who are writing exams today, oh God, this week. I pray for those who need you, oh God, who need, oh God, shelter, who need the armor and the shield of God. I pray for those who need safety and protection in their journey, oh God. Lord, I pray for those, oh God, who are looking for divine breakthroughs, for financial breakthroughs. I pray for those who are looking for job. Lord God, I pray for those who are looking for promotion, oh God. I pray for those who are looking, oh God, for justice, oh God, and vindication. Father, I pray for those, oh God, who are bereaved and are mourning right now. Lord, I pray for those, oh God, who need peace, who need tranquility. I pray for those who need joy. Lord, I pray for those who are worrying and anxious, oh God, that Lord God, you visit them today. I pray for those, oh God, who are looking for child, oh God, and for the fruit of the womb. Lord, I pray for those, oh God, Lord God, who feel hopeless, those who need comfort, that Lord, you answer them by fire today, oh God. Grant everyone, oh God, according to the desires of their heart, in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, I pray for you, bring hope, oh God, to them, oh God. Bring joy and peace to them, oh God. Bring assurance, oh God, to them, oh God. Bring faith to them, oh God. Comfort them that need comfort, oh God. Give hope to them that are hopeless. Give courage to them that, oh God, need courage. In the name of Jesus, Lord, I pray for your guidance. I pray for your protection. Lord, lead lead us, oh God. Guide us, oh God. Go before us. Make the crooked place to be straight. Break in pieces the gates of brass. Cut asunder the bars of iron. In the name of Jesus. And give all the hidden riches of secret places. Thank you as we go. Let the angels of your presence go with us. Abide with us. Lord, we bless you. Thank you, oh God. For today, thank you for our bishop. Thank you for our mother and the Lord. Continue to strengthen them. Thank you for the ministers of the gospel. Thank you for the praise team and the musicians. Thank you for those who have listened, oh God, by way of radio. Thank you for those who have come today, oh God. Lead every one of us, oh God. Meet us at the point of need. Abide and keep us from harm and from evil. And by your grace, bring us back again to this house to worship you. Blessed be your name. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Everybody say amen. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit rest and abide with us now and forevermore. Amen and amen. God bless you and go in peace. In Jesus' name. Put those hands and give God praise. Hallelujah.